turns off the phone and it messes it all up. Listen to this. I love this song.
Thank you so much. Thank you.
She has this new song out now. It's called Remember Me. It's featuring Bia, and it is so good. Correct me if I'm wrong, but what my impression was, it's about that, like, perfect time in a relationship, whenever things are just, like, at the high, and, you know, everything that the partner does is sexy and beautiful and cool, and you're just like, remember this time, because things get hard. Is that right?
Yeah, definitely. I mean, I think that it's multi-tiered. I think that it is a song about things ending, if that makes any sense. It's a song about definitely that, like, high point, sexy time. I love how everything your partner does is sexy. It's so accurate. But that time in your relationship when, like, everything is magical and you feel like you're, like, on a grand adventure together. But it is also, like, my best friend and I always talk about this kind of idea that all of the best things in life are hard for us to enjoy, because as we're feeling how magical they are, we can also feel them ending, and we can feel them, like, slipping through our fingers and going by too quickly. And so in that sense, I think it is about a relationship, but it also is about yourself and feeling like you'll never be younger, more beautiful, more capable, more involved in your life than you are now. And it's a bit of, like, a sort of a bittersweet kind of song.
I love that message. We had a girl at work who had a sign that she would write to herself. It was kind of like a self-affirmation that says, like, you will never be more fit. You will never be healthier. You'll never be younger. You'll never be stronger than you are today. You know, you can be, of course, but it was just a moderate, like, a motivation just to say, like, make the most of, like, where you're at right now. It can only get better. I mean, you can get more fit. I shouldn't say that you can't get more fit, but her thing was, she was, like, young 20s, and she's like, right now I could literally never be stronger than I am today. So make the most of it. And I think that's totally true. And it's actually a good reminder during quarantine, whenever all I want to do is eat Cheetos and Doritos and not
the odds are stacked against us.
How are you doing?
I'm doing well. Can you hear my cat in the background? Oh no, can you hear me?
I thought I heard something, but it's okay. I've got two dogs, so you'll probably hear them too, so it's fine.
It's my cat in the background. I'm doing okay. I feel like every day is a bit different, right? But I feel incredibly lucky and to be able to be, you know, sheltering in place. And that's something that not everybody has. So I feel really lucky for that. But yeah, I mean, I think it's definitely an odd situation, mental health wise, and to face yourself every day. So you have to kind of, like, stay creative, stay involved, and create, like, a new regime so that you can feel like a human.
You kind of talked a little bit about this, like, so you've been doing writing, FaceTime therapy, trauma work and stuff like that. So what specific things have you been doing, like, on a daily basis to feel like you're keeping your mind right?
Well, I've been journaling a lot, which I think is really important, self-reflection. I know that a lot of people think that's really stupid, but I've kept a journal, like a dear diary kind of journal, since I was like 10. Wow. And I just think it's really important for self-reflection to kind of check in on yourself, even in the morning, to set, like, okay, my intention for today. And it doesn't have to be, like, too hardcore. It doesn't have to be like, I'm going to, you know, learn a new language. It can be like, my intention today is to be, you know, a bad bitch in all things that I do. It can be like, my intention today is to stay hydrated. My intention today is to be my own best friend. And it just kind of helps you stay in touch with yourself and stay mindful. For me, that's been really important. Also, like, making food, staying creative and doing things that feel like I am interested in what I'm doing, you know, like doing things I've never done before. I think that's really important. Yeah.
I love that you've been journaling for this long. I have to ask, because you're a songwriter, do you go back to old journals and, like, look at things and, like, try to get inspired for new music through that stuff?
Yeah, I definitely do. Half the time when I go in to write a song with my co-writers or producers, I bring in my journal and I say, I really want to write about this time, or I really want to write about, you know, just these last few days or something like that. Because it's so, like, when you're in it, you're so in it. And if you have, like, a recollection of when you were, like, so in it, you know, that's the best.
Yeah.
That's the best material to source.
And of course, and I love that you